Good morning. So we had considered the sensible part of energy and temperature calculations and the energy load in a single duct constant air volume. But what we missed and did incompletely was the latent load calculations. So let's quickly make the schematic. We had the outside air coming. The outside air gets mixed with the return air, and what we have is a mixed air. From the mixed air, it passes through a preheat coil. A preheat coil. Then it passes through a cooling coil. Then there is a fan which pushes air to my zone. I have a reheat coil in a terminal box. I have the zone. And this is the return duct. And that's the exhaust air. Right, and then similarly we can have end zones in our case. But what we wanted to do, or what we left, was the latent calculations or the humidity calculation. So we are going to do the latent load calculation, and latent load obviously comes only to the cooling coil. So latent load calculation on cooling coil and humidity ratio calculation. Right, again we'll only be using the energy balance, and that's how we'll be able to calculate. But there are two conditions possible, since this is a cooling coil now, and in a cooling coil there are two possibilities. That cooling coil is wet, that means there is condensation happening, and I'll explain the process and why the condensation happens, everything, so it is very much clear. And the other is cooling coil is dry. So let's go back to a psychrometric chart or a TS diagram. If we look at the TS diagram, and we have a dome, that's from the thermodynamics now. We are looking at the base of thermodynamics. That's the dome we have. This is the saturated line, saturated vapor line. This is saturated liquid line. And possibly we are at this location somewhere. That's the moisture part. That's the vapor part what we have. The dry air part is separately considered. This is the vapor part. And if we look at that constant constant pressure line, this could be one of that constant pressure line. And we are over here at the start. That's our starting location. And there could be one. So this is a dew point temperature. That's the dew point. And that's the dew point temperature. So this is the given temperature, dry bulb temperature. Dry bulb temperature of my air. This is the dew point temperature. So my given air which is coming to the cooling coil might have a temperature of some 70 degrees Fahrenheit or 65 degrees Fahrenheit maybe. And the dew point temperature at this location could be something. Let's say the dew point temperature for this location is 57 degrees Fahrenheit. And our cooling coil is set to such that the cooling coil leaving temperature TCL is 55 degrees Fahrenheit. In that case, my air and my vapor, water vapor part, will both be converted to a temperature of 55 from 65 degrees Fahrenheit. So this could be 65 over here. This could be 65, and it is converting to 55 degrees. It is being cooled to 55. So this will come back to 55. So it is passing and it is below the dew point temperature. Hence, the vapor part of it, the water vapor part of it, will start condensing because it is below the dew point temperature and it will condense. In that case, my cooling coil will be wet. But let's say my DBT is already 70 degree Fahrenheit and my dew point temperature in that case, let's say the humidity and the things are such that my dew point temperature is 50 degree Fahrenheit. Let's say it is one of the case, this could be 60 degree Fahrenheit something, but let's say the dew point temperature is 50 degree Fahrenheit, and in that case my water and water, the water vapor and air both gets converted to 55 degree Fahrenheit as per the cooling coil set point temperature. And because the dew point temperature is higher, dew point temperature is 50, and my air and water vapor both will be at 55, it will not condense, it will not start condensing because the temperature of water vapor is higher than the dew point temperature. So it will be somewhere over here, right? So if we are somewhere over there, it will not start condensing and hence my cooling coil will be dry. It will not start condensing. There will be no water droplets. So when the cooling coil is wet and it starts condensing, there will be water droplets. And then water droplets will be collected and there will be some water out. That is the dehumidifying effect or dehumidification which is happening. In both cases the dehumidification is happening, but the water coming out is a condensation, that is the extra thing which is happening. Now, as I said, there are two conditions, so the two conditions will be formed. Based on that, my zone humidity will be determined, because the humidity over here will be changed, the humidity of the zone will be now determined using the two different formulas which we have. So in case my coil, the coil is wet and we still do not know what the dew point temperature and everything is, we do not need to go into all calculation. We can just directly use this formula and figure out that the coil is wet or coil is dry. So in case the coil is wet, my omega r, so omega r is the omega of the return air. So the zone latent load is known to us. So there is some zone latent load for the ith zone, and for the same zone, the return air will have some humidity ratio. The return air humidity will be equal to the zone humidity. That's at least you need to understand, because in the room, if we have some air and it has a humidity of omega r and the air is going out, the humidity of air which is going out will be equal to the humidity of air which is inside the room. So that should be clear enough. The omega r dot r dash, if the coil is wet, is given by Q latent of that zone which is given to us, which will be given to us, divided by 4840 V dot T plus omega CL wet. So omega CL wet means, for the omega CL, for the cooling coil leaving conditions, the cooling coil leaving conditions could be given to us that the cooling coil leaving set point temperature is 55 degree Fahrenheit and the relative humidity at the cooling coil leaving location is 90%. Based on that, we can figure out the omega CL wet, because this will be giving us omega CL wet. I just remember that value, it's 0.0083 kg of water upon kg of dry air, or lb of water upon lb of dry air. So we have this value available to us. This value will be given to us in the question. V dot T is the total volume flow rate of the air. That will be the flow rate of air in all the zones total, which is flowing to from the cooling coil. So we have this value of omega r prime. If the cooling coil is dry, then there is another condition which is omega r double prime. And this formula is given as omega OA plus QL or Q latent divided by 4840 VOA. And the VOA, obviously, if I make some change, the VOA is also equal to XOA into VT, because that's how the VOA is defined. The XOA is defined as VOA divided by VT. So we can make that change over here, and this could be replaced as XOA into VT as per the availability of the the values. If they are given the VOI, we can directly use the VOI value over there. But that's the two formula which we have. Now we want to determine that the coil is wet or the coil is dry. The very simple thing we can do is the omega R will be equal to mean of minimum, the minimum value of the two. And if the minimum value is coming as omega R prime, if we have two values, let's say, for example, if the omega R prime comes out to be 0.007 and omega R, this might come as 0.009 and this might come as 0.0085, then we have the two values. Now we can calculate, and we know that the two values are compared. So the minimum value is omega R double prime. So my omega R value will be equal to the mean of these two, omega R prime minus omega R double prime, omega R prime and omega R double prime, and the value comes out to be 0.0085. So in this case, my omega R is the minimum of the two, and looking at, because the value, minimum value is coming from the dry coil, we can say that the coil will be dry in this case. And it depends, whatever will be the condition. But we have the omega R value, depending on. So as we continue, we have two conditions, which is one of the dry coil, wet coil condition. And to remember the difference, in the wet coil condition, we have omega CL wet. In the dry coil condition, we have omega M. These are overall calculations. So we have N zones are there, and each of the zone we have some latent load in them, some latent load in the I zone, J zone, etc. All the latent loads are calculated and summed over here. So this is the sum of the latent load in the numerator. This is the sum of the latent load in the numerator. So we have the overall omega R prime and omega R double prime condition. Now, how do we calculate the omega R? The omega R is the minimum of omega R prime and omega R double prime. So how do we differentiate is, let's take an example. By using all the numbers which are available to us, omega L CL wet will be given, because it will be the cooling coil set point temperature and set point relative humidity will give us the omega CL wet. So maybe using the calculations, this comes out to be 0.0098, and omega R double prime comes out to be 0.00, let's say it is higher. So this comes out to be 12112. This means my omega R, which is the minimum, this minimum of those two is 0.0098. That means my minimum condition is coming from omega R prime. Omega R prime represents a wet coil condition. That indirectly represents that in this situation, in the working of my cooling coil in this specific case, we'll have a wet coil. So that's the way we find out the value of omega R. Then the omega MA will be, so omega R, we have already reached this location of return air. Now, which is mixed with the outside air, the mixed air will be omega of return air plus XOA. I hope you remember the XOA is defined as the fraction, which is volume of outside air upon volume of total volume flow rate upon the in the denominator, the volume flow of the outside air into omega of outside air minus omega of return air. So all the values we are available to us, we just have the value of omega M. Now the omega MA, we have a preheat coil over here, that doesn't makes any difference, because the humidity ratio doesn't change in the preheat coil. So the humidity over here, which is omega MA, is same as the omega MA over here. Now what we want to do is, we want to calculate the cooling coil latent load. So the cooling coil latent load again depends on two cases. If my omega MA at the entering situation is greater than the omega CL wet, that means my cooling coil has to remove some moisture. Higher moisture level to lower moisture level, it will remove some moisture, and in that case my cooling coil latent load will be equal to 4840 V dot T
into omega cooling coil entering, and the cooling coil entering location is equal to omega ma again minus omega cl wet. This is the case, this is the thing. If omega cooling coil entering is greater than omega cl wet, if omega cl cooling coil entering is less than or equal to omega cl wet, that means if the entering humidity ratio is already less than the leaving humidity ratio, then the cooling coil doesn't need to do any removal of moisture, and in that case the latent load on the cooling coil is zero. I hope this is clear. So the procedure is very simple. We have two formulae. Everything is derived, all the numbers are available to us. We will just find the value of omega r prime, omega r double prime. We take the minimum. The minimum value can come up from either of these, and it will represent either the coil is dry or coil is wet. Based on this condition, it is just an information for us that the coil is dry or wet. If it is wet, then there will be some water which will be collected from the cooling coil, from the condensation, and it should be removed from the cooling coil. Then we find out the value of omega r, which is from written, omega ma, which is over here, and then compare that omega ma and omega cl, which is higher or lower. If it is higher, omega ma is greater than omega cl wet, then I have a value of the cooling coil latent load. If it is not the case, then I do not have any value for the cooling coil latent load. I hope this thing is clear. If you have any queries, do let me know. Thank you.